You may wonder why I'm in your house talking to you about Inglourious Basterds today. Other people saw it at Cannes, their reviews came out, and they were what they were. But I saw Inglourious Basterds. I saw it twice. And I have something to say about it. You see, the way that nature is, when other critics review a movie, they just look at it and offer an opinion. When I see a movie, I look at it and offer my opinion. And therefore, it's much more difficult to elude my grasp. Because when it's my opinion, it's what I think. And when it's their opinion, it's what they think. Inglourious Basterds is 2.5 hours long. Some of Tarantino's best writing ever. But as a movie, and you're going to the movie theater to watch a movie, not exactly what you were expecting. I don't think this is necessarily bad. This could be a good thing if you were interested in a movie that had a lot of talking in it and people talking over and over again about the same thing until the point of exhaustion where you were actually so nervous and tense through the entire movie that you enjoyed listening to people talk over and over again about the same things. Not actually saying what they mean, but what the subtext is being the key to the entire thing so you could figure out what's happening later. Or maybe that's not your kind of movie. The thing is, ironically, I want to praise Quentin Tarantino. I want to embrace Quentin Tarantino. I want to make him feel better. I understand Quentin Tarantino. I see inside Quentin Tarantino. But Quentin Tarantino does not see inside movie audiences anymore. He sees inside his vision. That is what a director does. That is what a director does that is special. He has become a nattering nabob. He has become a guy who likes to talk a lot. He's a guy who likes the scenes to go on and on and on so that the audience, through his skill as a screenwriter, through his gifts as a director, which are improving from movie to movie, will be tense, will be unsure of what is going to happen. But is that satisfactory to the audience? That is what we need to know. Does a fine glass of milk being discussed for 20 minutes really do what audiences want it to do? Is that the kind of thing that creates $100 million grosser? Doesn't really much matter if you make movies for $10 million, but Quentin Tarantino no longer makes movies for $12 million. So the question is, 2.5 hours of basically 5 sequences where people sit around talking, tension building, since we know that somebody will be killed or scalped or murdered or go crazy at some point. Is that what audiences want to see? I enjoyed Inglourious Basterds. I liked Inglourious Basterds. I also liked his section of Grindhouse, Death Proof, in which there was a great deal of women sitting around talking. But the advantage of Death Proof was that when they got to the action, it was endless, pounding, go-forward action. Nothing in Inglourious Basterds matches that action for action. Brad Pitt, who is basically doing a character role here, quite brilliantly, I think, actually, I think it's one of his best roles, is not the action hero in this movie. It is not a movie about a group of guys, Jews in this case, the Bear Jew, somebody I identified with, even though it was Eli Roth, who hates me as much as I hate him. It is not a movie about those guys going across Germany killing Germans. We see a few Germans killed. We see a few Germans scalped. At the end, we see more Germans killed in different ways. But, I don't want to give away the ending, but mostly they sit around talking. And as I say, the craft is tremendous. The skill is terrific. The actors are great, particularly Christoph Waltz, who plays the ultimate evil German, not Hitler, but the guy who is the Jew hunter. Terrific performance by Mr. Waltz. And many of the supporting actors that Quentin has chosen. One of the things that is fascinating about this film is that there are no stars. It is not a movie about stars. Christoph Waltz's character is the primary star of the movie, but really, Brad Pitt, the girl whose story is a central part of the story of the movie, not really the stars of the movie. It is an ensemble piece. It is a true ensemble piece, for better or for worse. So that's really the story here. It's an art film. It's a big, gigantic art film with some great images in it. There's one image in particular that stays with me, though I'm pretty sure I've seen it before in some other form, which involves showing a film on something other than a screen, which I found kind of beautiful and wonderful and magical. But after waiting 2 hours and 25 minutes for that, I'm not sure whether everybody will want to. It's a movie that takes its time. It's a movie in which people communicate a lot in many different languages, though they often go to English, most often go to English. It has got big laughs, it has got big tension, and it does have a few action-filled moments, though basically, I don't even know they're really action-filled moments if you count hitting somebody in the head with a bat and then beating them to death an action moment. I don't know. Gaspar Noé has done it with a fire extinguisher in a very similar way, and not sure I would really count Irreversible as an action movie, but it's a good movie if you like people talking. If you're looking for Brad Pitt and a bunch of Jews on a romp killing a bunch of Nazis, you're not going to enjoy the movie so much. If you didn't like Quentin's grindhouse section, Death Proof, you are not likely to really enjoy Inglourious Basterds. Me, I enjoyed it, and I think it's kind of a middle film for Quentin. I think he's getting to where he's going. Either he needs to abandon the endless chatter, he could really use a producer who would tell him how to cut some of the chatter and make a tighter movie, or he can start making movies that are all about the chatter, using genre elements to ramp it up. But I don't think this is one of his finer works. But it's a perfectly good movie. And I think that the kind of negative to slight response at Cannes was very much a product of going to Cannes and everybody feeling a need to pick on a bandwagon and pick a side immediately on every movie. This is not a movie that deserves to be dismissed. But it is not a big commercial action movie either. It is a massive art project. And if Quentin wants to do that, and somebody will finance it, how can I argue against that? I think it's a good thing. The guy has great taste. The guy has interesting choices. But in the end, he mostly wants people to talk. Now, if I were to do a proper ending to this review, I would take the glass of milk. I would drink it all in one long gulp, because that's how Quentin rolls. And then I would kill some people under my house. But I don't like milk. So I'm not doing it. And I guess that's just the way it goes, because Quentin likes to talk, and I like to not drink milk. And if that's not the most important thing I've said in this review, I can't imagine what is. Except for, no, I don't have anything. And that is it. That is the end. That is the all. Bonjour.